The sixth bit of the ninth question says that ABCD is a rhombus. That means all the sides are equal and opposite angles of a rhombus are equal. If A is 78, then C will also be 78, and we are supposed to arrive at A, Y and X independently, and also the Z value. Another hint is that ECD is an equilateral triangle that is also been given. Therefore, each of these angles will be 60 degrees each. Now, this is 60 and this is 78. Then the total will be 138 angles. Now, coming into the triangle ECB, we have been given that this and this end are equal. Therefore, since these two are equal, these two are also equal. Therefore, EC is equal to CB, and these sides being equal, the angles will also be equal. Therefore, if this is X, this will also be X, and applying angle sum property to this, we have 2X plus 138 is 180, and X will be 180 minus 138 divided by 2, which comes to 42, 2x will be 42, and therefore x will be 21. Now coming to EDC triangle, we have 60 and 60 each, and this is sum is 60, but one of them is 21. Therefore 60 minus 21 will be the value of z, and z will be 39 degrees. Now this being a rhombus and a parallelogram, AD parallel BC with transversal DB, we have transversal AB, we have angle A and angle B. Sum of angle A plus angle B is supplementary, being co-interior angles of this AD parallel BC with transversal AB. Angle A being 78, now B will be 102 degrees. And coming to triangle ADB, herein we have AD equals to AB. Once again, the sides are equal. Therefore, if this is A, this is also A, then 2A plus 78 is 180 degrees, angle sum property of triangle ADB. And from that, we have A value as 51 degrees. Now we have A as 51, X as 21, and the whole angle has been arrived at as 102 degrees. Therefore, my Y will be 102 minus 51 plus 21, which comes to 30 degrees. Therefore, X is 21, Y is 30, and Z is 39.